My idea is an application of an already invented device used as a pseudo-free energy device, similar to a Type 2 perpetuum mobile. What represents a free energy device or a perpetuum mobile? Is a device that extracts work from ambient temperature, or a device that doesn't need a cold reservoir and hot reservoir. Second law of thermodynamics says that the heat spontaneous goes from hot to cold, and in order to extract work must exist a flow of heat. No flow, no work. So in conclusion, from ambient temperature, work can't be extracted. A normal heat engine is work equals QH minus QC, or heat pump that is QH equals to QC plus work. Work is needed to be used or generated. In the case of this device that is already invented and used in a new way, it spontaneously moves heat from cold to hot or to reservoirs that have the same temperature. This device will move heat to create a gradient without work input. After the difference is formed, the reservoirs can be hooked up to a heat engine to extract torque, decreasing the overall system temperature. The reason that it not breaks the second law of thermodynamics is because it transfers the heat through the negative temperature. The heat expressed as the total sum of the different aspects that keep energy, rotation, vibration, velocity at the molecular level. This device spontaneously changes one aspect from positive temperature into negative temperature, and the heat transfer towards the hotter the reservoir as radiation, and this radiation also is thought as having negative temperature. The device that is already invented and used in a new way as a free energy device is a laser. A special laser that where the gain medium is pumped by the thermal radiation or the far infrared emitted by the enclosure. And if the gain medium is a gas, it must be matched with the infrared flux by reducing its density to maintain population inversion. To maximize output, the cavity must be long and narrow. How narrow depends on how much time does the medium gas stay in metastable state. It has two ways to increase its flux, one by increasing its length, secondly by focusing. It has a minimal working temperature depending on the energy level necessary for lasing. For example, the peak emission wavelength at 300 Kelvin is 9.6 microns. Going below this temperature, the laser will stop working. So it must be designed for a minimal temperature of the environment that is working, and the trade is that it has less specific power or requires to be bigger for the same energy flux. I don't know if other than gas for gain mediums are possible because of the thermal energy of the interactions between molecules that will disrupt the metastable state. That's the second reason for a low pressure gas. This is in essence a perfect refrigerator.